Hi, I'm Ryan Lamb. I play Robert Martin in The Drowsy Chaperone.
Hi, I'm Ben Doss. I play the man in chair in The Drowsy Chaperone. And welcome to
Gettin Drowsy.
So no one told you that was gonna be this way. Your job's a joke.
Episode of Gettin Drowsy. I'm so excited. Are you excited, Ben?
Oh, I'm very excited.
All right. So basically what Gettin Drowsy is, it's behind the scenes of the musical The Drowsy Chaperone, put on by Canfield High School. And we're going to be going behind the scenes. We're going to be interviewing directors, cast members. We're going to be showing you the set. It's going to be awesome. And due to my schedule, we should have had this started like weeks ago. But I've never been able to edit ever since we started the show. So, improvise, what we're going to do, we have a bunch of footage over the show. Don't worry, it's not just from 1 week. It's from all the weeks that we've been working. So what we're going to do starting tonight is posting daily. So we're doing one tonight, tomorrow, the next day, so on, until the show is over. Or until we're out of footage. So that just depends. So we're really excited to do this.
And we thought, sort of as a little blast from the past sort of thing and a way to ease you into this new show of ours, we would go back to an old show of ours, Shrek the Musical. You've all heard of it. You all know it. We're going to be singing a carpool karaoke version of Travel Song with me as Donkey and my good friend Ryan as Shrek.
This is to our Shrek the Musical cast members from Millennial Theater Company, who actually gave me the idea of doing these daily vlogs. So shout out to them. Yep. We're going to put their social media links in the description and whatnot. So please go support them. I think they're looking for stage directors and stage managers and music directors. So for those watching that are music majors or really handy with stage managing, there you go. All right. We hope you enjoy.
You know, this may turn into the longest day of my entire life.
Oh, I got the perfect remedy for that.
Donkey, please, I'm begging you.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere. Cause the fun is getting there.
Yeah! Oh, what the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip.
Sing a song, hit the trail. Forget the maps, forget the guides. Before you know it, you've made strides with me.
And I know all I need all along is a path and a pal and a song. So I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, makes the time go by faster.
Why me? Why me?
This is nice.
Tell me, what was my crime?
Ooh, we are strolling.
As chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a cat who's wearing boots. That's crazy.
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine.
This is good cardio.
Won't someone please send me a sign?
Hey, look, a sign. You need a Pal Avenue straight ahead.
What did I do to deserve this, honestly? This ass of mine is asinine. Why me?
Oh man, what could be better than this?
Why
sing
me?
A song,
why
hit
me?
The road.
A simple answer
is the way
would be
to
fine.
Get around.
Oh,
you
someone
know it,
please send me a sign.
And I know all I need
to deserve this
is a path and a pal and a song. So
this ass of mine
and
is
I'm
asinine.
Having.
Why am I with you? That'll do, Donkey. That'll do. I'm a smelly ogre.
Yes, you are indeed.
Dragon!
Hey,
Hey guys, so we hope you enjoyed that number. It was awesome just to sing it, especially with Ben, because you know we've known each other for such a long time and we were so excited for the show to happen, but sadly it got shut down by COVID. But that's not why I'm here. The main reason that I'm interrupting this vlog right now is because it's 12:05 in the morning. I'm searching through my camera roll to find as much clips as I can to be put into the blog as our first blog. And you know, it's our kickoff, kind of. You know, so we want to make it huge, I guess. But I'm going through and I'm realizing, I'm like, oh my God, Ben and I, who are the hosts of this blog, don't have a lot of interviews with the cast or directors or anybody. And I'm thinking, oh my gosh, I can't believe we haven't done that yet. But have no fear, because Natalie Balestra and Abby Ambrose will be having their own segment on this blog every day this week. So we hope you enjoy their segment of Gettin Drowsy. Forgot to mention in the last video, this segment, it's for interviews that we haven't gotten yet. Enjoy!
Okay.
Hello.
Hey. That was overly dramatic.
Oh, blooper one already.
Yeah, already.
Okay. So we're just gonna do some fun little questions, just for the fun of musical theater, because we're all musical theater nerds.
And we're fun or something. I don't know.
That's right.
Okay. So the first question: if you could marry or date any musical theater character, who would it be and why?
Character.
Yeah.
Aaron Samuels.
For Mean Girls?
Yep.
Why? Wait,
I have zero clue why. I have zero clue why.
Jack from Newsies.
Oh, I'm with you there.
That's true.
So
that's true.
It's so basic. It's so basic, but it's just...
I'd kill to hear that note from Santa Fe right now.
I need time to create, like, one of those things that they do in the sports where it's like,
oh, like a bracket,
you know? I need time to create a bracket because you're asking me an impossible question right now.
There's too many.
You know you're a musical theater kid. You don't know sports terms.
I'm not gonna lie. Aldofa would be a good choice.
But Lafayette from Hamilton, he's just a really cool person.
His accent cool is... Name.
He's really cool, and I love his character, and yeah. Yeah.
Zendaya.
From what musical?
From Greatest Showman.
From Greatest Showman. Great,
yeah.
Okay. JD from Heather's?
Yeah.
You have a thing for sociopaths?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Good to know, internet world.
From American Horror.
What musical song do you relate to the most? Like, you could be the character singing that song in that moment. You feel like whenever you hear it, you're like, oh my God, that's me.
Ha.
I have one.
Yeah,
you guys think I'll go.
Yeah.
When He Sees Me from Waitress. Oh. Where she's talking about, like,
oh my God,
that's totally, she's like not wanting to fall in love with the guy because she's like, oh my God, what if I reveal myself too much and then he doesn't like me and then I'm just a pathetic mess of a person and I'm like, oh my God, Soul Sisters.
I think I'm gonna stick with my Mean Girls theme and go Stupid with Love.
Okay, that's a good one too.
You know, I've actually never thought about this, but Satisfied from Hamilton.
Yeah.
I don't know if I would necessarily relate this to this song, but I really like it. It's the one Esmeralda sings in Hunchback of Notre Dame. Ooh. It's on, I don't know if this is the title, like, word for word, but, like, On Top of the World or something like that.
Ooh.
I don't know. It's just kind of about, like, being given the opportunity to see something from a new perspective and taking it, which I really stand by. So, I don't know if I relate to that, but I definitely like the message that the song portrays.
I dig that. Why are all of ours about like heartbreak and not feeling good? And then you're like positivity.
To be fair, I didn't answer like the marriage question or whatever because I couldn't decide, so.
Hey guys, so unfortunately we're going to have to cut that segment short for this episode because, you know what, Natalie and Abby are doing an awesome job with grabbing footage, but it was just a little too much footage. So there's only so much I can do as an editor to keep things rolling without, you know, going too fast or keep the audience just sitting there looking at the same thing. And since the episode is already so long as is, I wanted to throw some at least like 2 or 3 minutes of clips from like the first couple weeks of the show before we start diving into clips of like Tech Week and whatnot. So that's what this next segment's for. Hope you like it.
Yeah. Oh, wait, who are you?
Oh, I'm the man in the chair, aka Ben Doss.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. How are you liking rehearsal so far?
Oh, it's great. Everyone else is setting up at the moment, and meanwhile, I'm playing with my my little ball keychain.
Your little ball keychain? Oh,
up on that.
Courtesy of who?
Courtesy of Lauren Jones / Ryan Lim, who's holding the camera right now.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. He's a pretty handsome guy.
Oh, he's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay, well, have fun.
Thank you.
I can sing it all. I can sing it all. Very fast. I can sing it very slowly. I do it now, but it would take hours.
I'm Trix, the aviatrix, queen of the sky. I'll circle through the spanish in my modern apparatus. I'm Trix, the aviatrix, I've gotta fly. I'll see you when they tie the knot.
Right here is where I would put the blooper reel for the episode. But you know what I thought? Wait, why don't I just make an episode, or pretty much just a video, of Gettin Drowsy bloopers after we're done with the whole series? And I thought, yeah, I'm just going to do that. Because one, I'm tired already. And two, I just feel like the bloopers that we have so far just should have their own video as a whole. So right now, we're going to cut it here. I hope you enjoyed the first episode of Gettin Drowsy. Tomorrow, we'll have more interviews and more behind the scenes and whatnot. We'll talk to some directors, stage managers, etc. And yeah, so tune in tomorrow. See you guys.